In this lecture, you will learn the fundamentals of what modern interface framework looks like, the features of the new UI toolkit, and the differences between the new system and the old Unity GUI. UIElements, which is now called UI Toolkit, is a new Unity API for creating user interfaces. According to Unity's own presentation, its goal is to create a unified way for designing and creating UI in Unity, both for the in-editor and runtime users. There are still two other APIs for creating UI in Unity, the legacy immediate mode GUI and the recent Unity UI or uGUI. But why is there a need in Unity for a new UI framework at all? If you have some experience with a recent Unity GUI that Unity developers have been using for more than 5 years now, probably you have already faced yourself different challenges and noticed various cases where this system just doesn't work or is very inefficient. In my own experience, I have created some applications where the UI was fairly complicated, with a lot of panels and different elements, and sometimes it was just a nightmare trying to work around the obvious limitations of the current system. Also, when you already have some background in Unity, previous UI API is quite intuitive. But when you come to Unity, for example, from a web development environment, then it's the opposite, and it can take some time to actually become proficient in it. Throughout the years, different developers have introduced custom UI systems through separate assets available on the asset store. They are based on recognized web technologies and languages like XML and CSS. But now, finally, Unity developers have access to an integrated solution, developed by Unity itself. This is an important step forward, because it's always better to use a framework developed by the software provider of the whole IDE, especially when it comes to an important layer of an application like user interface. So what are the biggest advantages of the UI toolkit? First, like I already mentioned, it's familiar and based on well-tested web technologies. Second, it's easier for teams to work on different parts of the UI. It's also more comfortable to handle version control. Another advantage is that it's much easier to reuse styles, templates, layouts, or even themes across different parts of UI or projects. And finally, the contextual event handling and data persistence. So it's more straightforward now to connect and bind data from the script to the actual label, for example, or a button. It's also easier to keep everything organized. Eventually, UI Toolkit will become the main UI framework available in Unity, both for runtime and in-editor users. So do not hesitate to learn it now, because even though it may seem complicated at first, you will quickly discover the advantages yourself. Now let's move on to talk about the actual tool we will be using. UI Builder is a so-called visual authoring tool, where you can build UI using UI components organized in a hierarchy and layout. So we will spend most of the time looking at a 2D blueprint of the UI design. But I want to briefly mention that still, all parts of the UI toolkit system are represented in three different ways in code, separated into style sheets based on CSS, UI documents based on XML that store hierarchy and layout of elements, and C# code, where we store all the data that can be shown in the UI and also where the behaviors for different events are defined, like for example, clicking a button. Finally, please remember that according to Unity, UI Toolkit is still in active development. It will become the recommended UI API for both in-game and editor development. But until then, there are some features that are available in Unity UI and immediate mode GUI that are not in UI Toolkit. That is especially true for runtime purposes. Following the changes made by Unity to the runtime engine of UI Toolkit, this course will be regularly updated to cover new features and modifications in the new versions. To sum up all the things, in this lecture, you have learned the fundamentals of what modern interface framework looks like, the features and advantages of the new UI toolkit, and the differences between the new system and the old Unity GUI. Now let's move on to setting up the Unity to actually be able to create some interface.